Government to investigate alleged corrupt Opnu transactions. Thick smoke causes multi-car accident in Belize. Police searching for alleged fraudster. And the EPA is nothing more than a toothless pool. I am the Recall Bullford, and welcome to tonight's edition of Uncut News. Nandalal says the PPP is on its way to fulfill one of its campaign promises. They are actively pursuing a criminal investigation into alleged corrupt transactions the coalition made whilst in government. First in their crosshairs is Winston Jordan. Nandalal claims that Jordan has been implicated in multiple shady transactions. Among them, Nandalal listed the hiding of the U.S. $18 million signing bonus from ExxonMobil, the alleged sale of state lands after the 2020 elections, and the alleged sale of several vehicles from the GRA to close associates. Today, the results of the 2021 CAPE and CSEC exams were released. Some 88% of the CAPE candidates in Guyana attained grades 1 to 5 passes, compared to a regional 87% pass rate. For CSEC, the country saw better grades than the regional average for biology, integrated science, human and social biology, as well as EDPM. Over 11,000 queries were submitted regionally last year to CXC, 98% of which were resolved. The remaining 2% were students who chose not to pursue the process any further. Nevertheless, the final results are still being processed to identify the top-scoring students. The government has just commissioned 3 new primary schools in Region 9. Some $18 million Guyana dollars was spent to construct the Pai Pung Primary, and $16 million for Rupertree and Fly Hill Primary Schools, respectively. Each school was also furnished at a cost of 3 million Guyana dollars. Pai Pung and Tiger Pond also saw the commissioning of teachers' quarters for 15 million and 9 million respectively. Given their remote locations, the schools also include living quarters for both students and teachers. Smoke from a burning rice field in Region 5 caused a multiple car accident on the Fowles public road that left one man hospitalized in a serious condition. The injured driver was identified as Wall Bacchus. According to reports, Bacchus was driving slowly on the road through the smoke when another car slammed into him from behind. The impact sent Bacchus's car into a parked car before flying into a trench. The third car then crashed into a truck. Bacchus was taken to the hospital while several others received minor injuries. Are you one of the chosen few that benefits from duty-free? Good for you! Check out these amazing vehicles that just arrived at Best Buy Auto Sales. This 2016 Toyota Harrier Grand Sport Edition, this 2014 Range Rover Evoque, and this 2016 Lexus RX 200T are all on sale. They are all fully loaded and come with all modern features. Call or WhatsApp 662-0844 for more info. Or visit their showrooms at Lot 171 Peterborough Street, Queenstown, or Lot 2 Lamar Street, and tell them the Rico sent you to get in on a sweet deal. On Tuesday night, a drunk cop crashed into a parked truck on the Good Fortune public road on the West Bank. The officer was riding with two of his colleagues from the Lagrange police station. Kai Chernu says the owner of the truck was inside his home when the impact happened, but it was when he realized that the cops were drunk that the truck owner insisted that the officer take a breathalyzer test. He was well above the legal limit. However, the owner of the truck decided not to press charges against the cop, since the two came to a legal agreement in which the cop will pay for the damages. Police in Mardia arrested a 33-year-old minor after his wife, 47-year-old businesswoman Denise Vera, was found dead in her house on Wednesday. Police found several marks of violence on her body, including stab wounds and evidence of strangulation. The couple was married for about 8 years, but due to an ongoing domestic dispute between them for some months, Vera opted to build a concrete structure and live by herself on their property. On the day of her death, her neighbor heard a loud argument between the two and then silence. When someone eventually came to Vera's shop to make a purchase, that's when they found her lying on the kitchen floor. The husband is currently in police custody. The Guyana Police Force has issued a wanted bulletin for 28-year-old Kevin Lloyd Lagadu, called Yusuf Ali Lagadu or Sheikh Yusuf Ali Abin Lagadu. Sounds like a scammer. According to the police, the young man is wanted for a series of fraud allegations committed in Georgetown. Told you he's a scammer. Anyone with information that may lead to the arrest of Kevin Lloyd Lagadu is asked to contact the Special Organized Crime Unit, SOCU, or the nearest police station. I mean, come on, anyone with that many aliases has got to be a scammer.
Boom! My name is Mudwater from Guyana Uncut. I have a big truck. Note, I didn't say I have the big truck. I have a big truck. When I need affordable parts for my truck, I only go to one place. Powered Automotive Truck Spares and Engine Parts. They stock parts for DAF, Freightliner, International, and Mack trucks. Also, all genuine Cummins engine spares. They're also the authorized dealer in Guyana for Hammer Parts. And as a wise man once said, don't DPS. Get your engine parts from PATSEP. Call 697-0171 for inquiries and tell them Mudwater send you. Boom out!
Some 371,007 people, or 72% of the adult population, have taken their first shot, while some 228,262 people, or 44.5% of the adult population, have received both jabs. For adolescents, 26,130, or 35% of the population, received their first dose, and 15,879, or 21.8%, are now fully vaccinated. And now for our stupid news of the day. You know what I think is stupid? Just how understaffed and under-resourced our nation's Environmental Protection Agency is. According to the head of the EPA Complaints Unit, Surjpal Singh, the agency is currently dealing with over 2,500 complaints spanning the length and breadth of the nation. And the complaints cover all manner of pollution, from dust and fumes from a furniture factory, all the way to noise complaints against houses of worship. This means that they honestly don't have the ability to properly address each complaint in a timely manner or with the requisite staff to deal with each unique case. To make matters worse, the system is very centralized, so they have to address complaints by region and not by the type of seriousness. And often, when they do get to it, people ignore the orders because they know it will be quite some time until the agency can actually follow up with the issue. If the EPA currently has small-time crooks running circles around them, then do you really believe for a second that the agency is empowered, independent, and has enough integrity to face down these multinational corporations that are currently setting up shop in Guyana? Of course not. And honestly, that is scary. The EPA is supposed to protect the environment, but if our environmental police are unable to effect serious change on our behalf and ensure our environmental safety, then our nation is in really big trouble. So we as citizens need to ensure that the EPA does its job. Send them letters, go to public meetings, and abuse them for selling out our land to the highest polluting bidder. Keep at it, and they have to listen. Because every good politician knows that to ignore the will of the people too long is pretty stupid. Don't miss the grand 50% off sale and get a free 1-month Digicel Prime bundle plan. Available at City Mall, Starbrook Square, Regent and Light Street, Marcy Turkine and Marcy Providence. Shop early, limited stocks available. Moving on to Uncut News, here's poll question of the day. Every day we pose a question about current events in Guyana, the region, the diaspora, and how you feel it relates to us. So you give your responses in the comments and we'll read the best ones in the following episode. Yesterday's question was, do you support the need for a third shot? Vanessa Davis says, third shot? It is too soon for a third shot in Guyana. Most people are only now collecting their second shot. I'm really scratching my head here. Jan Jyram says, I don't support the need for a third shot. Dane Charles says, I had both doses and I'm not taking a third shot. And Orin Angwe says, this guy said a third shot? How many times do you have to shoot someone to kill them? Apparently more than three times, I guess. So for tonight's question, do you think anyone from the coalition will actually be charged for corrupt transactions, or are they going to find a way to get out of this one too? Think about that question and tell us in the comments below. If your response is good enough, we just might feature it in our next episode. Anyway, that's all the time we have for tonight, and check us out tomorrow for another. Until then, I'm Rico Bulford saying good night, folks.
Hey, Uncut News viewers, thanks for watching. You can subscribe by clicking on this button over here, or click over there for more news. You can also drop a comment to let me know if you've made it to the end of the video. Goodbye for now!